Hey everyone, welcome back to Disney Sources Arena. So, Happy New Year. Right off the bat, I want to say Happy New Year. Right off the bat, I want to let you know this is going to be a new series for beginners. So, if you're a more experienced player, you probably want to avoid this because this is going to be for people that are looking for a new game and you're like considering Disney Sources Arena. I'm going to be helping you out. So, first thing right off the bat, when you start Disney Sources Arena, you're going to have to choose, after you get through all the tutorial stuff, you're going to have to choose between which way you want to go. Are you more focused on PvP? And if so, we can talk about some really strong teams to help you get going in that direction. I think there are two fairly strong teams. I mean, one is just okay, and the other one can really help you long term. And the one that's going to help you out on the short term,
where is it? How do I get to this? I gotta figure this out real quick. All
right, so in Disney Source Arena, if you come back to the homepage, and you go down here to quests, and you click on this little gold credit card with the Mickey Mouse ears on it. Click on that. That's going to be the pass holder. The pass holder is something that kicks in every twice a month, usually about the first and the 15 months, so it runs for 2 weeks. And in here you have these quests, and as you do the quest, you're gonna open up. And just as you play the game, it's a season pass essentially, but this is called a pass holder. It's a pass holder season. It lasts for 2 weeks. And you're going to be getting stuff just as you play the game. But there's also these quests. Now, as you can see, they have some that you can only get through if you use the pay, just like every other game. But if not, they have these free ones. Like, you know, where you go into a match and you're using Aladdin's Street Rat Strike ability. Or use Ariel's Electric Current ability. And these can be, and Aladdin and Ariel are two characters you get from the very beginning. You also see down here in the paid section, if you use Sorcerer Apprentice's Mickey's Shooting Star ability, you're going to get this. But you're not going to get that fulfillment if you have the paid section. So if you're just doing free, because these are all tunes that you get right from the beginning. You get another one from using Captain Hook's, a gift from Wendy ability, and Gaston Storms the Castle ability. And those are two other characters you can get very, very early in the game. And you can build a decent starter team around those, just using their characters you get for free, that you can make sure that you're doing these free pass holder things. And as you can see, I mean, if you're familiar with pass holder, it works the same in every game. The more you do, you know, you have your different treks. These are the free rewards. You know, as you play more and more, you're going to get just this free stuff. But also, as you complete those quests, it's going to help fill up your bar. And then these are the pay two, but we're not going to worry about those, because this is a free-to-play video for a new person getting into Disney Sources Arena who wants to play this game for free. So in my opinion, and I should have probably started this on one of my newer accounts, but it is what it is right now. And so we're just gonna jump into the early campaigns. Don't mind where I am, because we're gonna go back and we're gonna talk about who we're gonna have access to very early in the game. And as you know, it's not a big deal. You know, you're gonna start out. You can do F. Captain Hook's here, but he's like one of those free tunes that we talked about. That he has the gift from one of the ability, which is second ability, his first special that you're gonna use. And then you get down here, Sully. Yeah, Demona. Yeah, she has an ability they can use to get another thing. Yzma here. Monterey Jack, Sorcerer Mickey, who we've already talked about. So you get a little further in, you got Buzz, you got Hermes, you got Sven, you have Cogsworth Ariel, who we've already talked about. We have Hero here, who we haven't talked about. We have Gaston here. We have Jasmine. We have Syndrome. We have Sheriff of Nottingham. We have Aladdin, and we have Frozone. So to be able to do this Frozone node, you need to be, you can be level 19. So these are all tunes you can do that you can get access to before you're level 20. But here's what I want you to talk. Here's what I want you to look. Frozone is what we call a downtown hero. He's in a group called Downtown Heroes. He's very good downtown hero. Aladdin is in Kingdom, okay? He's in a group called Kingdom. Sheriff of Nottingham is also in that Kingdom grouping. Jasmine, also in that Kingdom grouping. Gaston, also in that Kingdom grouping. Sorcerer Mickey, Kingdom. Yzma, Kingdom. So yeah, I mean, you have a fair number of tunes, but these Kingdom characters can be really strong early game, and they're only going to help you get to one of the. They're going to help you like, just like in Star Wars: Galaxy of Heroes, just like in Marvel Strike Force. You know, you have those tunes that will help you build towards other tunes. Well, in this case, you have, you know. We'll go out to the Kingdom page, and I'll show you what I mean. So we talked about how you get Gaston can be open very early. We have Sheriff Nottingham who you can open very early, Aladdin who you can also get access to, Yzma, Jasmine, Sorcerer Mickey, you know who are part of that grouping. That you can have access to very early. I want to encourage you to go after those kingdom characters, whether it's Yzma, whether it's Jasmine, whether it's Aladdin, Sheriff of Nottingham, Gaston, Sorcerer Mickey, whoever it is. You know, I just showed you the grand campaign, you have access to, you know, all of these characters up until level 20. Now, like in most games, it's fairly quick to get up to level 20. You can do it in a couple hours or maybe in a day or two. Then once you hit level 20, it's gonna slow down a little bit. You're gonna see levels not as coming as fast. It's not like it's gonna be a dramatic slowdown. But there is a little bit of slowdown, and as you go along, you can see here we got all these characters. Here's Genie, he's another Kingdom character. Here's Kronk, he's another Kingdom character. Here is Quasimodo, he's another Kingdom character. And then, you know, so and this grouping will do you until you get to level. And this Quasimodo quest is 32. And then, as you can see, this Eve battle is 35. So, you know, once again, more Kingdom characters. And I want you to, and I really want you, and obviously you're going to have to do the battles to open some of these other characters. But my suggestion is that you focus on the Kingdom characters. Why? Because just like I talked about, just like in Star Wars Galaxy of Heroes, just like in Marvel Strike Force, it's going to help you get... it's going to help you find a good foundation, and it's going to help you get to one of the best legendaries in the game, who it just so happens at the time of that I'm taking this video, the mistress of all evils, the mistress of all evil event to get Maleficent, who is one of the better legendaries in the game, in my opinion, is open. The problem is, you need an assortment of Kingdom heroes, and you need an assortment of Kingdom villains. Now, who are those Kingdom villains, and who are those Kingdom heroes? Well, you can see three of them right here.
Mulan, Sorcerer Mickey, and Robin Hood for Kingdom Heroes. But they're all, that's three of them. And then three of the Kingdom villains that we've already talked about. I mean, we've talked about two of them. And just like we have in the Kingdom Heroes, we haven't, you know, we have the Sheriff of Nottingham, Yzma, and John Yu. We dive into the event, and you can see here, you know, who we need. So, Kingdom Heroes, we've already talked about Kronk. We talked about Sorcerer Mickey. We just saw that you need Mulan, because she's on the page. You also need Mrs. Potts. Now, the thing about Mrs. Potts is Mrs. Potts is going to help you out in two events. She's going to help you out in this Mr. Saval Evil to allow you to open Maleficent. But she's also required to, if you want Beast from Beauty and the Beast, then you also need Mrs. Potts. And then there's Robin Hood, who is, you know, another kingdom. And I'll make sure before we end this to show you what the locations for all of these tunes, so that you can be planning, okay, you know, this is where I'm going, this is who I need, this is where he is, blah blah blah, all this good stuff. The kingdom villains that you need are Yzma from The Emperor's New Groove, who we already talked about a little bit, Xuan Yu, who is the villain from the Mulan movie, the Sheriff of Nottingham, who is the minor big bad from the Robin Hood movie, Gaston, of course, from Beauty and the Beast, and Namari from Raya and the Last Dragon. Those are the characters that you need. In addition, I forgot to talk about this in the previous video, but you also need to level up a spell called Trigger's Tower, which we'll talk about later. And just coming back over here for the heroes, you also need Clock Tower to level up Clock Tower for the Kingdom Heroes. But the reason I'm telling you this is because if you do this kingdom, because they're gonna give you, you're gonna get Aladdin right off the bat. You're gonna have Yzma. You're gonna have access. They're gonna give you Yzma, or you're gonna have access to Yzma really fast. You're gonna have access to Gaston really fast, and you're gonna have access. So Sorcerer Mickey, Gaston, and Yzma right off the bat, and those are three of the 10 tunes that you need for this Mistress of Evil. One happens to be a hero, the other two happen to be villains. But the reason I'm showing you this is because if we go into a... I'm just going to go into this. I'm going to set up a battle. I didn't even know that thing went at all, because nobody told me about it. But here you can see this is a kingdom. This is one of my PvP teams that I have to be using. And it happens to have Jasmine, who happens to be a tank in this game, and then Xuan Yu, who has what we call, and we'll just look at the abilities real quick, just so you can have an idea. Suitors Beware, that's just a damage ability, and then this is where you put Raja out, and Raja is the tank. Raja is the one with the tank. So Raja, you summon Raja, and he becomes the tank. You can place on the field wherever you want. This is an ability called Acrobatic Assault, and that you can see what it does. Where it does damage, you gain evasion. If Aladdin's a teammate, he has a 60% chance to assist. And this passive ability that can has a chance to grant continuous healing. Then we'll talk. Then there's Xuan Yu. If we click on Xuan Yu, we can see here that he has his basic, the Sword of Xuan Yu. He has this. What do you see? Where he calls out his falcon, and his falcon does damage to flanking opponents. And this is now it's your turn. Where he basically runs up and headbutts you. And then this is a passive, bow to me. And then this is his leadership. Probably the best kingdom leadership in the game that you can get very early from Xuan Yu. And it says kingdom teammates gain the following: when they gain 12% speed bonus, and on defeat They have a 45% chance for Kingdom teammates to gain offense up for one turn. And then we go over here to Mari. I don't know why I keep... You know, Mari has her basic. She has her first special. She has her second special. And she has her passive. Yzma, same thing. Basic, special, second special, passive, and another passive. But you can really build if you go for Kingdom right off the bat. It's going to really put you in a strong position, PvP wise. Because although this is not as good as a legendary team, if you stick with long enough, it's going to lead you to a legendary. And it's just going to be a means to an end. So that's what I mean. You have to decide, do you want PvP? Because you can totally build out this Kingdom team or a version of this Kingdom team that will do you really well in PvP in this Source Arena. It will also, like I said, it will also help you get into raiding. It will also help you get one of the first legendaries in the game and one of the more powerful, so that you can, so if you decide that you want to build a, what is called a legendary soup PvP team, where you're just basically running five legendaries as a PvP team, and you're letting them do the work this way. But what I'm trying to tell you to do is one of my big recommendations is that you seriously consider going for Kingdom right off the bat, because like I said, they give you three of the 10 access to three of the 10 characters that you need to open left and right off the bat. So let's take a look at them, shall we? Let's take a look at all these characters, where you can go and what they do. So Genie is a support. You see, you can just click on this and it'll show you he's a support. So this is his role. Now keep in mind, this is my Genie. He's level 69. These are his stats. He's maxed out. He's gear 8. Your Genie may not be that strong. My Genie just happens to be, because I've been playing this for a very long time at this point. But we'll just jump in the abilities. You can see mine is maxed out. I could max it more, but I would have to get gear 9. I'm not to gear 9, so this is what it does. Damage, you can see what it does. It's just ally genies will assist, blah, blah, blah. This is his passive, where you'll take a debuff and it'll throw it from whatever character you denote on the team and it'll throw it on your enemy. Pretty good. This is a very high damage ability. You can see even at the rank that I have, it's going to do 6,100 damage and has an 80% chance to inflict silence for one turn. And this is passive that he has, and where he has a chance to randomly heal an ally. And then this is a duplicate, where he duplicates himself. It's really passive, powerful. And, but wait a minute. Well, I forgot to show you. Well, I can't show you where he is because I have him all. So we'll go. Same with Jasmine. Jasmine's very, very powerful. You can have access to her. You open, the Aladdin event very early in the game. But we'll just take you through and show you what she does. I already showed you what her abilities do in a previous thing. And so Aladdin's probably the weakest member of the Aladdin team. He just does what he does. Then there's Kronk, who is the first member that I have here of the team that you need for Yzma. You can see that you need for Maleficent. He is a defense character. Yeah, he's a defense character, which means he doesn't have a lot of health. He has you might think this defensive low, but it's not really low. But he is slow, as you can see. And then we have Maurice. Maurice, once again, you need him for the Beauty and the Beast team. So if you're thinking about going for Beast, Maurice is somebody that you need. Quasi, who we talked about, Quasimodo.
who I could take up to 7 stars, but I don't quite have enough money. I mean, I'm over a million, but don't want to do it right now. He's a defensive character. Maximus, who you need for Rapunzel. So if you're thinking about going after Rapunzel, who is the leader of the princesses, who we'll get to here in a little bit, you need Maximus for that. Robin Hood, who we already talked about, he's the second of the 10 of the 10 kingdom characters that you need in order to get Maleficent. Then there's Mulan, who is another member that you need to get for Maleficent, so that's 3. Then there's Mrs. Potts, who is number 4, but as we talked about before, you need Mrs. Potts also. In addition, you not only need her for Maleficent, but you also need her for Beast, if you want to go after the Beast. Sorcerer Mickey is the 5th member of this Maleficent team. He's the last member of the Kingdom Heroes that you need. And then there's Anna, who you need for Elsa, obviously. She has the Frozen leadership right here, but you need her, but she just happens to be Kingdom in this particular game. Then there's Rapunzel, who's the leader of the princesses, who's really good, and there's Esmeralda, who you pair with Quasimodo for a tower that will enable you to unlock Claude Furlough, who we'll talk about in a little bit. Then there's Raya, whose event, I think, is going on now, but you need her. But she's an adventurer, and you need Namari. You need Namari first, but we'll talk about that in another video, but for this, we're just going over. So Raya is going to be one of the harder kingdom characters for you to obtain right now, but more on her in probably another video. Then there is Finn Rider, who is also a person that you need for Rapunzel. And that's really all you need him for, because he's not that good. And then there's Cogsworth, who's not that good, but you need him if you want the Beast team. He's one of these teams that you're going to have to, that if you decide to go after Beast, you're never going to use outside of going for Beast. Same with Belle. I mean, Belle is a princess, so Belle does have some value. If you're trying to get in the princess, if you're trying to get a princess PvP team together, you might want to go after Belle. She's one of the better ones. Lumiere, much like Cogsworth, you're never going to use him outside of going after Beast. You also need him for if you're going for Beast. Snow White is one of the newer legendaries in the game. She's a legendary princess. She's the only legendary princess in the game. And they just added it this year. We'll talk about Snow White probably in another video. And then there's Cusco. Cusco's another toon that they added earlier this year. He's Kingdom. I haven't used him. So I don't know much about him, honestly. Then there's Beast that we've talked about. Legendary Kingdom Hero, the Beast. And then we'll move on to the Kingdom Villains, and we'll talk about them. And then we'll go through, and I'll show you where you can get everybody. Unlike the Kingdom Heroes, there's a lot fewer of the Kingdom Villains. But the best Kingdom leadership in the game happens to be on this side. And that is Shen Yu, who has the best Kingdom leadership. So if you're running PvP team, whether it be Kingdom Villains or just Kingdom whatever, you're going to want Shen Yu for his leadership. Because you also need Shen Yu. Shen Yu is the leader of the Kingdom Villains. He's also one of the toons that you need for Maleficent. Namari, we talked about, you need her to get to Raya, so you need Mari before you get to Raya, and you also need Namari for getting Maleficent. Then there is Yzma. Yzma's a healer. She's the support healer for this side of the Maleficent game. You need Mrs. Potts. Mrs. Potts is the healer for the other side, for the Kingdom Hero side of the Maleficent team. And yeah, Sheriff Nottingham, we talked about a little bit. He was much better when the game came out. He's still very good. He's not as powerful as he was when the game came out, because you know how power creep works in these games. But you need him for Maleficent. Gaston is the tank of this side of the Maleficent thing. And if you're wondering, Kronk is the one for the hero side, and Gaston is the one for the villain side. And that's it for the Maleficent team, for who you need for Maleficent. Aside from that, Jafar, pretty powerful too, better than Aladdin. Mother Gothel, who you need if you want to go after the legendary Edna, who they just put in the game not too long ago. If you want to go after Edna mode, you need Mother Gothel leveled up. But do the Maleficent team first. Claude Furlough, who we talked about, you need Quasimodo and Esmeralda for. You go into a tower, you put together a team, that's how you get Claude Furlough. And then Maleficent, you can see I'm very close to having her open, I just don't yet. But she also has, we could just look at Maleficent and why she's so good, because she has 6 abilities. Not going to lie, I really haven't played with Maleficent a whole lot, but I'm working on getting her on all of my accounts. You can just see what she does. You can see what her basic does. It does hot damage, can use damage. I mean, you can see it for yourself, what each of these abilities are going to do and how they're going to affect, you know, what she does. This is her first special called Force of Thorns. And you see all the abilities for yourself. Second ability, Cast My Spell. Passive, where she turns into a dragon and she does a ton of damage. Like 75, 50, 75. Another passive, Serve Me Well. And then another passive. So she has three abilities, 3 passives, and then after that she has the leadership, the Mistress of All Evil. And you can see what it does. And I think that you should consider going after Maleficent first is because she can be one of the hardest tunes in the game to get. But she's also going to open you up for a lot of other things. It's very easy because you can do, having these kingdom tunes, like we talked about, the five kingdom heroes for the hero side and the 5 kingdom villains for the villain side. It will allow you, if you just follow my advice, it will allow you to do this whole thing if you level them up all the way. Because Gadget is the last one here. You need to get Gadget, you only need to have your tunes at level 70 in tier 8. And probably you can do this before this, but just to be able to make sure you can do it. This is a level 75 where you need all your tunes at gear 8, which is very easy, and Maleficent will help you get there. And you need heroes for that. You need kingdom heroes for that. Kingdom villains, so Sean Yu in this, and you can see I'm already here where I was able to get. Sally here, all I needed to be was level 67 and gear 7. But we'll go through it and I'll show you where these tunes are so you can write them down. So we talked about the ones that you can get all the before
you're 35, and I'm and you can get, you know, you so talk about who you can get kingdom wise to get to level 35, and obviously you're gonna need to leverage, because you're not gonna have access to all these tunes right off the bat. And so who you will need, you're just gonna have to mix and match. And as you pick up some of these other kingdom tunes, you're gonna have to put down some other tunes. But I want to encourage you that if you're just thinking of getting into Disney Sorcerer Arena, that Kingdom Villains is the way to go. I know I could have probably done a better choice, a better opportunity of explaining this. If you have some questions, please leave me a comment in the video and let me know, hey, I have a question with this. I have a question about that. I have a comment about this. What do you think about this? Please let me know. We'll have a talk about it. It's fine. It's not a big deal. Please like and subscribe to this video if you found this video helpful. Let me know. I really appreciate it. And I try to keep this video as short as possible, but there's a lot of information. So if you do have questions, leave me a comment. We could talk about it more. Anyway, thanks for watching. I appreciate it. Have a good one. We'll see you. Bye.